continue, before you try and meditate, is through very severe discipline and observances in your daily life. So it's not just when you sit quiet for meditation, you must control yourself. Even in your routine life, you have to be very tough and very disciplined. And if you do that in your daily life, then your mind will come under control. And when you sit still, it will sit still. The mind will come quiet. Otherwise, it will knock you about. So what are the things that you need to do in your daily life? Look, this is what is required. It says, to start off with, you must be established in satya. That means truth. Now, what do you mean by established in truth? It says simply this. What you think, you must say. And what you say, you must do. You think that's easy peasy. We are all doing that. We are such straightforward people, such honest people. What we think, we say, and what we say, we do. Surely it's easy peasy. I'll show you how easy it is not. Haven't you noticed, you know, when you suppose you are tired and you go home after this Hinduism class and you want quick rest and then watch some TV program for relaxation, when you go home, your uncle from Nottingham has arrived. And you go, because you have to make small talk with him. And he says, aren't you pleased to see me? And what do you say? Oh, yes, uncle. Inside you're going, no way, no way. See, you already compromised. What you think, you don't say. In the name of diplomacy, else you'll have a fight with your uncle. Suppose you say, no, I want to do rest, and why are you here? That's the truth. And if you said that, the uncle will say, huh? How dare this very rude fellow. So you are, see, by just living in society, we already start compromising. And if you want to become a Rajyogi, means a person who wants to discover God through meditation, you are not allowed to have that diplomacy. You have to be severe. What you think, you say. Haven't you seen, I mean, when you go to your school and you say, good morning, and you had such a horrible night, you didn't sleep all night, you had nightmares, and you didn't get proper breakfast, and they're saying, good morning, and you say, yes, good morning, it's not good morning, it's a bad morning. And yet you say, good morning, see, without thinking what you're saying. So what you think and what you say don't match. Straight away you should say, no, very bad one for me, maybe good for you, not for me. But you never do that, do you? Because it's considered to be not polite. So you always say, good morning, and good morning, and it's not a good morning at all for you, it's a nasty day. But you still immediately compromise. See, that's how tough Rajyogi is. So he says, what you think, you must say. It doesn't stop there. He says, what you say, you must do. Now, you may think you are all honest youngsters here. And of course, you are all, you know, fulfill what you say. You know, you carry out what you promise to do. I'll just give you an example how tough that is. When you finish the class here, of course, you're going to look at each other. And I'm going to tell you, see you next week. And you're going to say, yeah, see you next week. See the problem? Suppose next week you got flu and you don't come here. And I say, see you. Now I have to see you. I have to jump in my car, get your address from the office out there, jump in my car, come to your home, look in there, you know, use sat-nav and find your home, knock on your door, and you come out sniveling, what? Okay, I told you, I see you, I've seen you, bye-bye. You have to do that. You say, I can't do that, Dilip uncle. This is too much. See? When you make simple comments that I'll see you or I'll do this, I'll meet you tomorrow. How do you know you'll meet the person tomorrow? He may be ill or you may be ill. But you said I'll see you tomorrow. So you have to, you know, tell your dad, I told him I'll see you. I have to see him now. Dilip uncle said, you must be established in truth. Your dad will say, oh, nuisance. This boy is a nuisance. Basically, this is what is required. Now, the reason why I'm just showing you in a light-hearted manner, that Rajyoga may appear easy, and yet it's the most toughest. Because it forces you to be very disciplined. Why does it force you to be disciplined? This is why. If you follow what I'm telling you, what you think you say, and what you say you do, rigorously, this is what Rajyoga promises you, then within a few months, few years, you will become such a joined up person because your thinking, your speech, and your action, your deeds, and your words match. So you become a very powerful person. You'll discover yourself. You'll become feel like a giant. If you establish yourself in truth alone, just truth alone, It will turn you from a very simple person into a very dynamic person, a very grand person. Because that dignity it gives you, you feel so sure about yourself, because you, everything is so well joined up in your system. Your inside is joined up. Your thinking, your words and your deeds are joined up. And you, before you realize, you are no longer the ordinary, you know, person, you kind of fickle person, all that is gone. You turn into a great, very powerful personality. Just one, I just gave you one discipline, like a dynamo. Just establishing truth gives you tremendous power. So this is just one of the requirements, disciplines that you require in your daily life before you are considered fit to sit for meditation. See how tough? It doesn't stop there. There are 10. You don't need, for your GCS, you don't need to learn all the 10. I'm just giving you one to show you how lovely it is and yet how tough it is and how important it is, and yet we all fail. In fact, you know, one of the things that Gandhi became very famous for is because Gandhi said, I'm going to experiment with truth. Because he thought that this is the word truth, being established in truth, is a very central feature. If you can just be that, do that, everything else will sort out. You'll discover God. So he said, this is the experiment. His autobiography is called Experimenting with Truth. That's all of Gandhi, see, just following this one discipline. There are other disciplines in before you are ready for Raj Yoga, before you sit for meditation. And that's another one is a killer. I mean, most youngsters say, no way, I can't follow this, it's too much, I won't do it. This one is itself a killer because most people can't follow it. I mean, I keep failing all the time. I'm going to tell you, see you next week when I finish, and I'm in trouble straight away. So it's through carelessness we keep becoming fickle and we lose our power. One other discipline that is required for Raj Yoga, and this will make you go, oh no, is called Brahmacharya. Now, Brahmacharya in simple English means, translate says, no lovey-dovey. Now, you look at it, yes, we are not lovey-dovey. You see, this is the problem. You may think you are not lovey-dovey. But so the moment you look at those dancing girls, if you're a boy or, see the handsome man kind of, showing them, Hrithik Roshan showing his muscles, you go, if you're a girl. You see, the moment you do that, you are no longer Brahmachari. It means you are becoming lovey-dovey. You're getting ticklish, that we are finished. So all of the youngsters will say, no way, we are not going to do this. So Raj Yoga says, no lovey-dovey. Even in your dream, you can't fall in love and send a text message to a girl. See, he's already very disappointed. I'm just pulling your leg, don't worry. The thing is, this is the strictness, the toughness of the Raj Yoga, path of Raj Yoga. You'd be very severe, very strictly disciplined. If you are able to become that disciplined, then you are now ready to sit for meditation. Otherwise, you're not even ready to start meditation. This is the Raj Yoga, the fourth pathway. So what happens is this. It's nice to talk about the theory. What actually happens? When you succeed in meditation in Raj Yoga, then you can hold your mind still. The mind can come under your control. Just you can say shush, and the mind shush, stops. Thoughts stop even. Can you imagine the power you just... Because you've been established in truth and brahmacharya, you can do that. You can stop it like that. And the moment you do that, magic.